What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're finally doing it. It's dry out. You can see we got some nice dirt here. Got the ramps out, got the SMT10 and the Losi LMT out today. We're gonna drive both trucks, do a little comparison of them, mainly just a video comparison. If you guys like this video, I'll bring them back out and do some more technical comparisons of them, talking about the differences in the way the trucks handle, how they're built, how they drive. Obviously, my SMT10 is heavily modified. You can go back in my channel and see all of the videos where I've built this truck from the ground up. My Losi LMT is basically stock. The only thing really different is the body and those wheels and tires. Both trucks are running Jconcepts wheels and tires. The LMT has gold gears on it. The SMT10 has the JCT tires on it. We'll be running 2S LiPos in both trucks today, both the same exact battery, an SMC 7200 milliamp 2S. So to start out, I'm gonna drive each truck around a little bit, get a feel for them both, and then maybe try to do some timed racing in a way. Set up a little course, make a lap, see what time it runs, and then try out the other truck and see what kind of time it'll run to. Overall, I just wanna get a feel for both trucks today, driving them back to back and kind of show in the video side by side a comparison of how they handle and how they drive. I think that's enough talking. Let's get ripping. After a little bit of a shakedown with both trucks, I'm gonna try to get some footage now of more technical turns and jumps and kind of like I'm trying to race actually. So far, there is a little difference in the feel of driving the trucks to me personally. While I do love the way the LMT handles, and honestly, I think it's the better handling truck out of the two, for some reason, I still get the feel of it jumps like an RC, like a truggy would. The SMT10 jumps more like a solid axle monster truck to me. I know the footage may not show that, but that's just kind of how I feel while driving it. And I know maybe that's just my driving style as well, so that's not a definite for everybody, but that's just what I'm getting after that quick little shakedown. I will say the steering is a whole lot better on the LMT, and I believe that's mostly because of that servo saver. Might have to see if I could find another servo saver like that to fit the Holmes Hobby servo that I have on the SMT10. That Proline Big Hip servo saver works well to protect the servo, but it doesn't do the greatest in allowing the truck to steer the best. I've never had amazing luck with it, but it protects a very expensive servo, so that's why it's still on there. Speed-wise, I also think you could probably see that the LMT is a little quicker. I could maybe get the SMT10 quicker with a gearing change, but I really don't want to get it too hot. I'm comfortable with where it's at right now. So now we're gonna do some laps and see how the trucks compare on a lap. I'm gonna start on the backside of the orange ramp, jump over it. I wanna come through this curve here to see how the truck handles in the loose dirt. Make a U-turn around there, come back through the loose dirt in the curve, jump the wire ramp, make a U-turn around there, and then jumping over the orange ramp will be my finish line. I'm gonna see what I could find in my bag or some rocks or something to use as some turning points, and we'll see how the trucks fare. Right as I was getting ready to say the steering on the SMT10 was definitely its limiting factor, the screw came straight out of that steering linkage, the Proline Big Hit, and that was the nail in the coffin for the SMT10 for the day. I do think with another servo horn, something more like what the LMT has, this truck could run just with the LMT. I find it jumped a little better, especially coming off this orange ramp here. But mainly when you got into the open area, it was way too wild. I couldn't hold the truck straight, couldn't steer it where it needed to go. That's nothing on the SMT10's part. That's just an aftermarket servo saver that I have on there. So we'll have to try this again when I get another servo saver on there. I was gonna end this video off with some freestyle between the two trucks, now that I've gotten some driving behind them. But the spring from this servo saver is completely gone, so this one's done for the day. We'll still get a little freestyle in with the LMT, and we'll see how you guys like the video. We'll come back out and make another one if you guys are enjoying it. So that's it for today, guys. Like I said, I'm really impressed with boat trucks. I enjoy driving boat trucks. I'll let you be the judge looking at the footage. Let me know which one you think's best. If you have an SMT10 or an LMT or maybe both, let me know down in the comments below which one you think is the better truck. I think they're two completely different trucks built for different reasons. They're both capable of doing amazing things, both capable of having a lot of fun. Like I said, if you're interested in more of a technical breakdown between these two trucks, let me know in the comments below. Make sure to share this video, like it, subscribe, all of that good stuff, so I can see that you guys are liking this video and want to see more like this. I think I'm gonna do another video like this after I get another servo horn for the SMT10. And then, like I said, if you guys like it, we'll do a more technical breakdown of these two trucks, comparing these two trucks and really getting down to all the details. I had a lot of fun out here today. I hope you did too, tagging along with me. As always, thanks again for watching. Peace.